further.
Sure.
If you guys want one together, I'm happy to take it for you. Just let me know.
Yeah,
of course. Yeah, very, very sharp claws.
I'm sure I've read a long time ago. Maybe some tourists tried to cut the claw or pick one up.
Quite
valid.
Yes, I mean, they don't usually use their claws for defense. They're mainly for climbing. But yeah, they are very sharp, so you definitely don't want to mess with an angry koala, because they can inflict quite a lot of damage, even if they're not trying to hurt you. They can, just because their claws are so sharp.
If you're not used to people, they're not going to.
Exactly. No. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I mean, yeah, if you try to approach a wild koala and you're going to pick it up, it's not going to have any idea of what's going on. If they see that, stranger, this big giant lunging towards them, they're going to take that as a threat, and that's when they can hurt you. Even these guys here, most of them aren't used to being handled, so if someone did try to pick them up, they would probably freak out a little bit. No, all of these ones are born here, so koalas are not actually native to Western Australia, so any rescue koalas would go to a closer facility that could look after them. Yeah, it wouldn't be very good for the koala to send, a sick or injured koala all the way over to Western Australia, because they are very susceptible to stress. So
how many bales of hay do you have
traveling, so far would suggest them that more. But all of these guys here are